Support comes from Missouri Forest Products Association, committed to sustainable and sound conservation of the state's forests, which support more than 41,000 Missouri jobs, resulting in a $10 billion industry. Choosewood.com.
From the St. Louis Public Radio Newsroom, this is The Gateway. It's Tuesday, March 5th. I'm Jonathan Aul. The Francis Howell School Board will soon vote on new curricula for Black literature and history. Board members said they wanted something that was politically neutral. Supporters of teaching the subjects are still concerned.
If they don't agree to this curriculum, then what was their intent? Was their intent to get rid of more?
St. Louis Public Radio's Chad Davis will have an update that's coming up on The Gateway. The U.S. Senate is expected to vote this week on a bill that would provide funding to St. Louisans harmed by nuclear waste. St. Louis Public Radio's Kate Grumke reports.
The Radiation Exposure Compensation Act is for people harmed by the U.S.'s World War II-era nuclear programs. It's set to expire in June. Missouri Senator Josh Hawley says the Senate will vote on standalone legislation to extend the funding. The bill also expands the fund to include some parts of St. Louis. Hawley says this shouldn't be a partisan issue.
This is a moral issue. The government has exposed these good Americans to nuclear radiation without their consent, usually, without any support, definitely. Now the government needs to make it right.
The Missouri Republican recently tried to attach this funding to other legislation. Those efforts were unsuccessful. I'm Kate Grimke, St. Louis Public Radio.
A Branson-based Christian sports camp was the center of a sexual abuse investigation in 2009. Camp counselor Peter Newman was arrested and later sentenced to life in prison for abusing more than a dozen campers at Kanakuk Camp. A decade later, journalist Nancy French's reporting found that the camp was protecting Newman and other predators. A group of activists and survivors are now calling for the passage of a Missouri House bill that would expand the statute of limitations for child sex abuse claims. Attorney Bobby Thrasher is representing a former camper who was abused by Newman. Thrasher says the bill would expand the statute of limitations to before a person turns 41.
It would extend the statute of limitations by 15 years against an institution, 10 years against the perpetrator, and it would give individuals who are grappling with the abuse they've suffered, the traumatization that they experience, it would give them more time.
Thrasher made his comments on St. Louis on the Air. Some homeowners in St. Charles County can apply to sell their homes to the county for demolition. St. Louis Public Radio's Lauren Brennecke reports residents living in flood zones are encouraged to move.
The county received $15.7 million in federal funds to buy homes in St. Charles County, Portage de Sioux, West Alton, and parts of St. Charles City. More than 900 homes are expected to be eligible. Robert Myers is the director of the Planning and Zoning Division for St. Charles County. He says only about 100 homes will be chosen.
It's less about being immediate relief for those homeowners from the 2019 flood, and it's more forward-looking. We're trying to take people out of the path of future flooding.
The application window opened March 1st, and the project is expected to conclude in early 2027. Myers says they don't plan on using the sites to develop housing again. I'm Lauren Brennecke, St. Louis Public Radio.
The St. Louis Board of Aldermen's Transportation and Commerce Committee has advanced a plan to provide $15.3 million in accrued interest from ARPA funds to the expansion project at America Center. The motion passed unanimously yesterday with 5 votes. Explore St. Louis President Kitty Ratcliffe expects to get final additional cost numbers later this week from architects and the Board of Public Service, which is managing the construction project. She says in addition to this $15.3 million, they need another additional $25 million to complete construction. Ratcliffe says rising costs have caused the project to go far over its original $210 million budget. A behind-the-scenes star of the music world died last week. Bob Heil designed concert equipment that helped the music industry grow, all while running a successful gear shop in Marissa, Illinois. St. Louis Public Radio's Jeremy Goodwin reports.
Bob Heil advanced the state of concert sound with better amplifiers and mixers in the 1960s and 70s, then developed better microphones. Heil also developed the first concert-ready talk box, a guitar attachment that Peter Frampton made good use of. In a 2006 oral history recorded by the National Association of Music Merchants, Heil said he was able to impact the music business because of players who loved his gear.
All we did in those days, those things changed the direction of rock and roll live sound. Can one guy do that? No, but he certainly can give you the truck to do it with, and then a whole bunch of people drive it.
Heil died after a battle with cancer. He was 83. I'm Jeremy Goodwin, St. Louis Public Radio.
The Francis Howell School District made national headlines when it canceled its Black History and Black Literature courses. After protests from teachers and students, the board agreed to reinstate it only if it was, in the board's words, a politically neutral curriculum. A new version will be before the board later this month. St. Louis Public Radio's Chad Davis has been covering the developments. Chad, what's in this new curriculum for Black History and Black Literature?
The Black Literature curriculum primarily remains the same. The original curricula had four units, and the proposed curriculum also has four units, and most of the topics are the same. It involves learning about different viewpoints in Black literature and reading books and such that will offer kind of like mirrors and windows and such in order to understand different identities and the reader's own identity. The main changes, though, kind of happen with the Black history curriculum. And in that, it kind of takes a completely different approach. So in the original curriculum for Black history, it was six units, and most of them kind of focused on, I guess you could say, big picture questions where they will ask students about, what does it mean to study Black history? Also talking a little bit about what are the historical and modern day struggles for Black people and looking at that type of context. But in this new one, it actually takes a more chronological approach. So instead of kind of having some of those big picture questions, we get more of a like a linear history that starts out with like ancient Africa and then it goes to the present day and the modern day. And to be honest with you, a lot of parents or some of the parents that I've spoken with, they actually kind of like this new take because that chronological history may be a little easier for students to follow. And one of the people who I spoke with, Harry Harris, who is a Black parent at Francis Howell, he said that that's one of the reasons that he likes this new curriculum.
The heart is still there. The wording on these standards is going to look different. 110% understand moving it more towards a historical timeline.
The subtext to all of this was the board felt that the curriculum was, in their words, woke or too much pushing a certain political agenda. Do you think those concerns have been allayed? And do people who want that to be part of the curriculum, are they going to be satisfied with this new curriculum?
One of the parents who I spoke with, Carrie Zukowski, who has two students in the Francis Howell School District. She says, you know, it's up to the board now at this point. And at that March 21st board meeting where they plan to vote on this curricula, she kind of says, you know, if they don't vote for this or if they're not, if it looks like they still have a bunch of issues with this, then maybe it shows that the social justice standards really weren't the issue with the curricula and that they really are more opposed to the Black history and the Black literature classes as a whole.
The district's done exactly what you've asked them to do and possibly a little bit more, and they've done it quickly and in a way that was very transparent and open. So if they don't agree to this curriculum, then what was their intent? Was their intent to get rid of more than just the Southern Poverty Law Center standards?
Do we have any sense whether the board will approve this new curriculum?
I did ask the board president. I sent an email to the board president asking for his thoughts on this, and I didn't get a response back.
St. Louis Public Radio's Chad Davis, thank you.
Thank you for having me.
The Gateway is a production of St. Louis Public Radio, a member-supported service of the University of Missouri, St. Louis. Music by Ryan McNeely of Adult Fur. The editors in the St. Louis Public Radio newsroom are David Cazares, Brian Munoz, Fred Ehrlich, Brian Moline, Alex Hoyer, Lara Hamden, Brian Heffernan, and me, Jonathan All. And from the St. Louis Public Radio newsroom, this has been The Gateway.
Support comes from the Missouri Forest Products Association. Missouri produces wood pallets, railroad ties, white oak barrels, hardwood floors, and more. Details on the variety of products made in the state are at choosewood.com.